Will a narrow bank angle V6 make 4,000 horsepower? We're going to try and figure that out today, but we're starting with the most important part, which is the rotating assembly. It will consist of forged parts with a billet crankshaft, quality stars that are on plus 15 on everything, PVT on all cams, single turbo setup with direct injection, and also my favorite fuel, which is nitromethane. For exhaust, we are using a tubular race header with no cats and no mufflers. We don't need any of that where we're going. Next, we are watching our flowchart here and seeing what is going to be a problem as soon as we increase the RPM. So as you can see there, our first issue is going to be the compressor size, or the exducer size on the compressor side. That brings us up to a nice rounded 2,079 horsepower. As you saw, we are increasing our intercooler size as well as increasing our compressor size all the way up to 120 mm. That's where that's going to be fine, I think. Next, we're going to up the boost a little more so we can see what the engine does. Let's see if we can get to 4,000 horsepower. We're at 2,900, 3,200, we're almost at 3,500 without running into severe issues. As you can see there, we're tapering boost a little bit, so that means typically, as you might have saw with every engine build, I will go and increase the spring and lift tension after I verify everything else isn't a problem. And so far so good. Our header size is a little bit restricted, 112% to be exact, but that is fine, that's what we need for flow. As you see there, we're increasing our spring lift tension as well as lowering our compression a little more just to get the engine to cooperate. I mean, 3,800 and well, 3,900 now is no joke. That's a lot of horsepower for a 3.6 liter engine. That's moving. That's a lot of power. And if you have a favorite engine that you would like to see me build, do let me know down below. And while you're down there, do hit that like button if you like this type of content. That lets me know that you like this type of content. Anyway, my YouTuber stuff out of the way now. Let's get back to the video. We hit our number 4,000 horsepower. We are at 4,049 horsepower. Trying to see if we can get a little more out of this engine. I don't think we are going to be able, but giving it the good old try is always important. So we're messing with our AR ratio on our turbocharger, and we're also messing with our intercooler size. We got it up to 63 so far. I don't think we're going to go a little more than this, I don't believe. See if we measure the compression a little bit and change it to see if it does anything. So far it doesn't. I don't think it's going to be that beneficial to the engine. Let's see. Will this help? Yes, okay. So it helped a little bit. Let's just get it back to where it was. I think I'm going to leave it here. So we're going to do two dyno pulls. One looking at this big old engine, and one looking at the graph. So let's see what this machine sounds like. Hope it's good. Oh wow, this engine sounds absolutely incredible. Thank you so much for watching, and if you stayed to this part of the video, do hit that subscribe button down below. I figure you might like it around here. Anyways guys, have yourself a fantastic day, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye bye.